Bunbury's past. The Noongar Aboriginal tribes were the original inhabitants, benefiting from the fresh waters and fertile soils of the region. Early settlers chose Bunbury as a place to live, at the mouth of the Preston and Collie rivers, on a harbour known as Tumbana Bay. The town was founded by Lieutenant Henry Bunbury. Settlers arrived from 1839 onward, and by 1870 there were 300. Bunbury became the centre for a timber industry, sandalwood, production of horses, and farming produce. A large jetty, a quarter mile in distance, was constructed. By the 1890s, Bunbury had achieved the infrastructure as a transport hub. A railway from Boyanup was opened in 1891 to transport timber. The rail connection to Perth was made in 1893. Timber mills and yards were opened near the jetty. Work started on a breakwater in 1897. Coal from nearby Collie was transported through Bunbury. By 1900, the business district and settlers' houses were looking prosperous indeed. Bunbury was the principal port of the southern district, with a large bank, money order, telegraph service, savings bank, four churches, and two schools, including Bunbury High School. There was a court, jail, and steam-powered flour mill. A wooden lighthouse showing a light for a distance of 12 miles was erected in 1870. Population had reached 3,000 people with regular visits by steamers. During the First World War, a substantial dairy industry was established with a butter factory in Bunbury. Bunbury's role as a wheat terminal was strengthened in 1937 by the construction of a large silo near the port, ironically on the eve of a world slump in wheat prices. Fortunately, timber prices moved upwards, and the loss of overseas supplies with the outbreak of the Second World War stimulated demand for West Australian timber. There was, however, very little local manufacture, and tourism became a major industry with visitors from the goldfields. There were many activities, boating, surfing, and fishing, and a variety of organized sports, tennis courts, golf courses, croquet, and bowling greens. In 1950, the town boasted of 7 hotels, 3 hostels, and about 20 guest houses, which offered a wide variety of accommodation. Black Beach became the best known attraction, with a bathing pavilion and many other conveniences. With the popular use of motor cars, Bunbury became the center of a number of all-year weather roads, with scenic and historic drives radiating from the town. Industrialization of Bunbury began in the 1950s, including the mining of mineral sands, the opening of a chemical plant, bulk fuel storage tanks, and an enlarged concrete silo. Tensions developed between industrial development and environmental preservations, reaching ahead by 1970. By 1991, the population had reached 25,000, and today it's 50,000, the second largest city in the state. Bunbury now has over 800 ships visit annually. Bunbury today. During the last half of the 19th century, Bunbury developed as a dynamic, vibrant city. Bunbury was a transportation hub with rail, road, and ocean connections servicing the prosperous agricultural hinterland of the southern district. A comparison of old photos with Bunbury today illustrates the expansion. One notices the expansion in the port and the development of the central business district. Although some of the old stores remain dating back to the 1920s and 30s, much is new. In the center of town, it's a large, looming white building built by Alan Bond and called the Milk Carton. The sea dominates the town not only as a shipping port, but as the center of recreation with swimming, surfing, and sailing. The beaches attract visitors still. There are lots of new hotels to accommodate the visitors with recreational pursuits and pubs. Scuba diving is popular, such as diving on the old shipwreck, Lena. Some visitors just watch the birds and wildlife, including sea lions and the numerous dolphins that accommodate their interest on the beaches. Many of Bunbury's older buildings have disappeared, and it's hard to find the older settlers' cottages. There's been massive reconstruction of large, modern, expensive houses in Bunbury. The Lord Forest Hotel is a particularly large, luxurious hotel located near the center of town. It's hard to find large apartment blocks in Bunbury, but one noticeable extension was the conversion of the old wheat silos into luxurious apartments overlooking the yacht harbor. Merriston Hill is the site of a particularly expensive real estate development and a large rotary lookout overlooking the city. The Lighthouse Hotel is a substantial structure overlooking the ocean and the Bunbury Lighthouse. Bunbury boasts of some excellent cycling routes and walking trails located throughout the city and a very active campaign from the Heart Foundation to take up walking. One of the trails leads through a mangrove swamp with lots of interesting wildlife to Pelican Point, another site of expensive real estate and canals. Like most of Bunbury, Pelican Point is located directly on the ocean with beautiful sand beaches. On the way back from Pelican Point, I passed the woodchip industry, export point, and mineral sands, and drop into the Geograph Bay Wine Festival that's being held on the weekend. From there, it's a Guinness at the Irish pub. Thanks for joining me, dear viewer, your host, Don, on this quick tour of Bunbury, past and present. I do hope you have a great day.